How are you doing, Liara?
I'm a bit overwhelmed, to be honest. The Shadow Broker had more resources than you can imagine. Here, come on over. He had top-level access to the Turian and Asari governments. And more than one Solarian Dalatros traded intel. And now it's ours.
You're not gonna turn into a recluse with creepy information on everyone in the galaxy, are you?
I can understand the temptation. I've got all the secrets of the galaxy at my fingertips. Give me 10 minutes and I could start a war. But I've got a purpose. Helping you stop the Reapers. That will keep me honest. You know, relatively speaking.
Have you found anything useful yet?
The Shadow Broker knew about the Reapers. Perhaps that's why he offered to help prove Saren's guilt to the Council.
He didn't want Saren to succeed.
He also knew that the Collectors were Protheans, repurposed to be Harbinger's puppets. There's even some data on the Protheans. I think he knew what was coming and was looking for a way to survive.
Why was he still looking at Protheans? They gave us the warning and the conduit at Ilos, but we've used those.
The Shadow Broker seemed to think there was more out there. Perhaps the Protheans had other plans. Or maybe he was just grasping at anything that offered some hope.
How'd you know what the Shadow Broker was?
I didn't. I had no idea what to expect when we finally found him. But I researched pre-spaceflight cultures during some of my Prothean studies. I know a bit about the Yogg. There's more on the terminals if you want to look. They're a fascinating culture, and a terrifying one.
How's Farron doing?
As well as you'd expect, after 2 years of intermittent torture.
You gonna be okay?
I don't know. He wants to work, so I'm letting him help. Maybe it takes his mind off it.
So, you and Farron?
No. He's been through a traumatic ordeal. He's emotionally fragile and needs to heal. He's very grateful to me for saving him. But it would be irresponsible of me to take advantage of that.
It was good talking with you, Liara. Let me know if you need anything.
I think what I need right now is a friend. I can't leave for too long, but spending all my time on this ship. Maybe next time you come by, I could come up to the Normandy.
It's not a good idea, Liara. Let's keep it professional.
Of course. I understand. I'll be here if you ever need me.
Shepard, glad you stopped by. We don't get many visitors.
Take it easy. You've been through a lot.
You're probably right. I never did say thanks for the rescue.
Liara never gave up on you, Farron. I just helped.
I'm still amazed Liara came for me. I'll never forget what either of you did.
I can log that in the archives for you, sir.
I see you met the secretary.
For 2 years, Liara didn't stop looking for you. You two must have been close.
She's a good friend. Better than I deserve.
How are you holding up, Farron?
I'll be all right. I wasn't always strapped into that interrogation chair. Drell can mentally escape into old memories. It came in handy on the bad days.
How many times did the Shadow Broker hook you up to that contraption?
A lot. It gets fuzzy. He made the guards watch, as an example.
What will you do now that you're a free man?
I want to help Liara rebuild this place. But after that...
Your schedule's getting full, sir. Let me sync it to your Omni-tool.
No thanks, I'm fine.
How did you and Liara both end up looking for my body?
Cerberus headhunted me and Liara to steal your body from the Shadow Broker. I was working for the Broker at the time, and he's the one who scraped up your remains in the first place.
What turned you against the Shadow Broker?
He started working for the Collectors. You weren't their first victim. I am... was an information trader, not a slaver.
How do you think Liara's doing as the new Shadow Broker?
Operations are almost fully recovered after a slight dip in efficiency.
Ever since we repaired the network, Liara's been glued to the archives. I caught her sleeping at her desk more than once. She's busy, but I think she likes it that way.
Looks like you've made a friend.
The drone follows everyone. I don't know why the broker kept it around.
I'm a shell for a specialized data processing VI, custom built to your specifications, Shadow Broker.
It helps coordinate the network's massive information feeds, but it could use a different interface tone.
You deemed my default personality sufficient for your needs, Shadow Broker.
I wish it would stop calling me that.
Take it easy, Farron.
Thanks.
What does this console do?
This is the video surveillance access point. I've queued up the archive footage you requested on your last visit, Shadow Broker. Remember, you can zoom in for more detailed viewing and can pause anytime during playback. Aria Talok, Omega. Sinan Al-Jilani, Citadel. Keeper 20, Citadel. Matriarch Athita, Ilium. Not Torsk, Tachanka. Elias Kellum, Omega. Jacob Taylor, Normandy, SR2. Subject Zero, Purgatory, ship now defunct. barrier to lock. Omega.
I had a wonderful chat with your friend Tally. She's not what I expected from her psych report. I like her.
It's good to have her on the team.
Quarians are so fascinating to me, but they also make me a little sad.
Why do they make you sad?
Their environment suits are so beautiful, but with their immune systems, they're trapped inside. I wonder what they look like under those helmets. Or what their skin feels like under those suits.
Do you have a moment to talk?
I always have time for you, Commander.
I better go.
Okay.
Maybe we'll talk later.
Shepard, how can I help?
Have you got a minute to talk?
Actually, wanted to talk. Medical matters. Aware that mission is dangerous. Different species react differently to stress. Aware you come by a great deal. Have had other species become attracted to me before. Awkward. Not interested.
Wait a minute, Borden. You're just yanking me around, aren't you?
Shocking suggestion. Doctor-patient confidentiality, a sacred trust. Would never dream of mockery. Enjoy yourself while possible, Shepard. We'll be here studying cell reproduction. Much simpler, less alcohol and mood music required.
With something?
I'm more interested in just talking for a bit.
Sounds good. I could use some downtime. There's always something, right? The way some people talk, we may as well be dead already. Hard for the crew to relax on this kind of job.
No kidding. The next Normandy gets a lounge.
They better not need to do this again. Rebuilding everything was a pain in the ass.
I can verify that.
Yeah, I bet you can. I doubt they'll front the money to stitch me back together if we screw it up. It's a hell of a job, isn't it, Shepard? Being the good guys.
Wouldn't be the high road if it was easy.
You've got to figure, if all the people hoping we win stood up, the Collectors would have a much bigger fight on their hands. Claws, whatever. I bet we have a lot more friends once we win. Hope we live to see it.
I hear that.
Anyway, I need to get back to work. Good talking to you.
So the Collectors were once Protheans, repurposed by the Reapers. What a sad end.
Makes you wonder if the Keepers in the Citadel were once something different.
Commander.
I assume everything is going well up here?
It was, until the thing started questioning my every move. It won't let anything slide.
You were deliberately falsifying maintenance reports, Mr. Moreau.
Not falsifying, tweaking. I always round up on task times. It makes us look good when we come in under.
Harmless self-promotion. Edie can ease off on that.
Very well, Shepard.
Yeah, go pout. I win.
Joker.
Right, no hard feelings. Good game.
That's it for now.
See you, Commander.
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
Shepard.
Is there something wrong?
Yes. Now that you are here, though, it seems more difficult to talk about.
I've got time. Take it at your own pace.
Thank you. I fear I've already done that for too long. I had a family once. I still have a son. His name is Kolyat. I haven't seen him for a very long time.
Did something happen to them?
I abandoned them. Oh, not all at once. Nothing dramatic, no sneaking out in the middle of the night, no final argument or slammed door. I just did my job. I hunted and killed across the galaxy. Away on business, my wife would tell people. I was always away on business.
How long has it been since you talked?
10 years. He showed me some of his schoolwork and asked if we could dance crazy. We did that when he was younger.
What sort of dance is that?
I checked my extranet contacts. I expect an update on my next target. The console plays music. Oh, unfashionable. Kolyat jumps into the room. My father runs around in circles. I scoop him up, toss him into the air. He shrieks, laughs, spin me. The console beeps. I put him down. Click the message. Father, he pleads, tucks my sleeve. I need to read this, I say. I don't look at him.
You never mentioned this before. Why now?
When my wife departed from her body, I attended to that issue. I left Kolyat in the care of his aunts and uncles. I have not seen him or talked to him since.
If we're talking about this, he must have contacted you.
No, he didn't. But my condition. I've been judging my life, measuring what I've added and what I've taken away. I used my contacts to trace Kolyat. He has become disconnected. He does what his body wills.
What's wrong with him? Is he hurt?
Something happened that should not have. He knows where I've been, what I've done. I don't know his reasons, but he has gone to the Citadel. He's taken a job as a hitman. I would like your help to stop him. This is not a path he should walk.
You don't hire a raw rookie for a contract killing.
I'm afraid someone may have seen we share a name and assumed we share skills. I don't know why he would accept the task.
To be closer to you, maybe?
That thought haunts me more than any other.
Thane, I don't have your contacts and I don't have your tracking skills. Why do you need my help for this?
I don't need your help, I want it. The last time I saw my son, they wrapped your body in sea vines, weighted it with stones. He tries to pull from me, calls for her. The hammer lift her off the platform, they sing like bells. The fire has gone to be kindled anew. He begs them not to take her away. They let her body slide into the water. He hits me. Don't let them. Stop them.
Why weren't you?
Rains. It always rains on Kaje. Warm water pours down his face.
I didn't mean to make you relive that.
Perfect memory. It is sometimes a burden.
What made him go to the Citadel?
Years ago, I prepared a package for him. A relic of my ill-spent life. I had Volus bankers store it, and arranged for delivery when I died. He acquired it early. I don't really know how. I did wet work on the Citadel around the time his mother died. That may be why he went there.
I'll get us to the Citadel as soon as possible.
Thank you, Shepard. I'll be meditating until you need me.
I was just thinking about you. Gabby and Ken would make a great couple. I just doubt they'll ever realize it. The Normandy runs so quietly. I'm not used to hearing my footsteps when I walk. One of the girls in navigation thinks she might be pregnant. Even aboard a Cerberus vessel, life finds a way. Come back later. I'm sure I'll have more to talk about.
I am glad you came. I must ask for your help. That is not easy for me.
It's all right. Just tell me what you need.
When we met on Ilium, I told you about a very dangerous person I was pursuing. Using the information you obtained, I have located her. She's been going by the name Morinth. I would like to apprehend her before she disappears again.
Didn't you say you'd pick up her trail after our mission?
I know where she is, right now. In a month, she may be gone. This is the best opportunity I've ever had.
Where is she?
Omega. A nightclub called Afterlife, which seems a perfect place for her to hunt.
How important is this?
Killing her has been my focus for 400 years. It is the most important thing in my life, and the reason I became a Justicar.
Tell me about her.
She is an Ardat Yakshi. It is a term from a dead Asari dialect. It means demon of the night winds, but that is mythology. She is simply a very dangerous woman who kills without mercy.
So is an Ardat Yakshi a special kind of murderer?
Morinth suffers a rare genetic disorder. When she mates with you, there is no gentle melding of nervous systems. She overpowers yours, burns it out, hemorrhages your brain. You end up a mindless shell, and soon after, you are dead.
Why isn't this ever mentioned in Asari literature or art?
When we were primitive, there was much fascination with Ardat Yakshi. Some cultures worship them as gods of destruction. Now the Asari have a place in the galaxy, and they don't wish this defect to be widely known. As far as I know, only three exist today. Two chose a life of seclusion. The third ran.
Morinth.
She ran, and I am sworn to kill her.
I don't know that I blame her for running.
When she fled, she proved her addiction. She was not taking a great moral stand. She simply wants to keep killing. She is a tragic figure, but not a sympathetic one.
Can't she abstain?
Each encounter gives her strength. The effect is narcotic. The more she does it, the more she needs to do it. She will never stop. She can't.
So you hunt down these Asari just because they're born with a genetic condition?
It manifests with maturity. When one is diagnosed, she is offered the chance to live in seclusion and comfort. If she refuses, it shows her addiction to the ecstasy she gets from killing her mates. There is no redemption for such a person.
They have to choose between prison and death?
It is an addictive condition. Remember how adaptive we are. If Morinth does not want to be cured, she won't be.
This is definitely worthy of your full attention.
She confuses her victims, twists their feelings. They will do anything for her favor.
We need to stop her.
Thank you, Commander. There are no words to express what this means to me. There is one thing more. This creature, this monster, she is my daughter.
I cannot imagine what this is like for you.
I do not want pity, Shepard. I do not accept it. My daughter's condition is my fault, and my redemption lies in killing her. Do not pity me. Simply understand my situation.
How did all this happen?
I spent my youth on the move, adventuring. I killed people, mated with them, or just danced the night away. I learned so much, experienced so much, and then my matron days came. I could finally sit back, bask, and enjoy my family. But in one moment, it was all taken away.
It sounds terrible.
I sat in a med lab while a nearsighted doctor droned at me, and I learned that nothing was as I thought it would be. I gave up all that I possessed. I own nothing, claim nothing. All my knowledge will die with me. Now my purpose is to destroy my own children.
Those moments change you.
And I've hundreds of years left to live with that. I say too much. Forgive me. Help me find my long-lost daughter. And kill her.
We'll go find Morinth.
Commander, what can I do for you?
You have a minute, Miranda?
Of course. I've been meaning to speak with you, in fact. I wanted to apologize. I didn't fully believe you'd be up to the task, and it seems I was wrong. Frankly, based on what I've seen, I wish Cerberus had recruited you earlier.
I trust you, but I don't trust Cerberus. Your experiments crossed a line.
All the time, yes. But I recall a Spectre who crossed a few lines while hunting down Saren and the Geth. And we'd be lucky to have you. Too many join us out of simple xenophobia. We need more people here for the right reasons.
I saw your bases years ago. You were using Rachni, Thorian Creepers, even Husks to make your own army.
The Husks were already dead, the Thorian creatures were mindless, and the Rachni were abandoned once we understood their intelligence. We weren't breeding an army, we were breeding expendable shock troops for high-risk scenarios. How many soldiers died in Saren's attack on Eden Prime? How many would have lived if we'd had just a dozen Rachni soldiers on our side?
What was Cerberus trying to prove by experimenting on children like Jack?
A mistake, no question. Not mine. And one that was corrected once we discovered the extent of the experiments being performed.
With your intelligence, you could have landed any job you wanted. Why choose this?
Because I still envy the time Morden spent with the Special Tasks Group, working with people as smart as he was. Cerberus never tells me that something is impossible. They give me my resources and say do it. And they've given you even more. A new life, a new ship, the elusive man's personal attention.
What? You disapprove?
No. I'm just impressed. You're... well, look at you. A colony kid growing up in a prefab unit, losing even that when the Batarian slavers arrived. And you've done more than I could. Despite everything my father did to make me perfect, you're the best humanity has to offer.
You always bring up your genetic tailoring. It really bothers you, doesn't it?
This is what I am, Shepard. I can't hide it. The intelligence, the looks, even the biotics. He paid for all of that. Every one of your accomplishments is due to your skill. The only things I can take credit for are my mistakes.
I can't admire your body or your mind? You give your father too much credit. Yeah, he gave you gifts. But you can be proud of what you've done with them.
Oh. Thank you. Perhaps I wouldn't mind if you admired my body.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean it that way. We need to stay professional. Keep our focus.
Yes, you're right. This is too important for anything to cause friction. Thank you for coming by, Commander.
Shepard, need me for something?
Have you got a minute?
Can it wait for a bit? I'm in the middle of some calibrations.
Talk to you later, Garrus.
I'll be here if you need me.